I welcome you all to our 12th standard general maths video class. I hope you are all good and safe. Last class we have learned some problems from the exercise 3.4. Last class we have learned how to solve some partially factored equations. Today we are going to solve some more equations based on three concepts. Today we are going to learn three new concepts: rational root theorem, reciprocal equations, and then the last one is non-polynomial equations. Based on these three concepts, we are going to do exercise 3.5. It's a very, very easy one. Okay, first one, rational root theorem. For some polynomial, we can find some few roots by a trial and error method, as we know. But guessing the factor or root by a trial and error method, it's not an easy one. Here, our rational root theorem helps us to guess the few roots or guess the roots. Okay, find a rational root theorem. Let an xn plus an minus 1. See, what's our theorem? First we are going to take an x power n plus an minus 1 x power n minus 1 plus etc plus a1x plus a0 via polynomial. Then p by q is a root. With p comma q equal to 1, then p is a factor of a0 and q is a factor of an. Now I am going to give one. X square minus 5x minus 6 equal to 0. Now I am going to take the constant term 6. For this, the divisors will be the divisors of this 6 will be 1 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 plus or minus 3 plus or minus 6. So by the rational root theorem, these values are the possible roots of this equation. This is what our theorem says. Okay. The next one, reciprocal equations. Look at your book. There is one definition. 3.1, page number 120. A polynomial p of x of degree n is said to be a reciprocal polynomial if one of the following condition is true. Here, the polynomial p of x is said to be a reciprocal polynomial if one of the following condition is true. That is, if p of x equal to x power n into p into 1 by x, or p of x equal to minus x power n into p into 1 by x. If now a polynomial p of x of degree n is said to be a reciprocal polynomial of type 1 if p of x equal to x power n into p into 1 by x. If a polynomial p of x of degree n is said to be a reciprocal polynomial of type 2 if p of x equal to minus x power n p into 1 by x is called a reciprocal equation of type 2. Now, look at your book, page 121, there is one theorem, theorem 3.6. A polynomial equation a n x power n plus a n minus 1 x power n minus 1 plus etc. a 1 x plus x a naught equals 0 is a reciprocal equation if and only if one of the following two statements is true. That is, an equal to a naught. Then a n minus 1 equal to a 1, a n equal to a naught, a n minus 2 equal to a 2, etc. As well as a n equal to minus a naught, a n minus 1 equal to minus a 1, etc. Okay. Now we are going to see the proof for the theorem 3.6. Now I am going to consider the equation P of x equal to x a n x power n plus a n minus 1 x power n minus 1 plus etc plus a 1 x plus a naught equal to 0. Now I am going to replace x by 1 by x. So we can consider this as equation number 1. Now I am going to replace x by 1 by x. So P of 1 by x equal to a n 1 by x power n plus a n minus 1 1 by x power n minus 1 plus etc plus a 1 1 by x plus a naught equal to 0. This is P of 1 by x equal to a n by x power n plus a n minus 1 divided by x power n minus 1 plus etc plus a 1 divided by x plus a naught equal to 0. We can consider this as equation number 2. Now I am going to multiply both sides by x power n. Multiply both sides by x power n. Then the equation 2 becomes x power n p into 1 by x equal to a n dou by x power n into x power n plus a n minus 1 dou by x power n minus 1 into x power n plus etc plus a 1 dou by x into x power n minus 1. So x power n plus a naught x power n equal to 0. What will happen? This is equal to x power n p into 1 by x equal to x power n will get cancelled. So a n plus x power n will get cancelled. There will be x power minus 1. It will move to the numerator. So we'll have x a n minus 1 plus here plus etc. Here we'll have a n minus x power n minus 1 plus a naught x power n equal to 0. So this is equal to x power n p into 1 by x equal to, this can be written as a naught x power n plus a 1 x power n minus 1 plus etc plus a n minus 1 into x plus a n equal to 0. Now we can consider this as equation number 1. Now look at the equation 1 and 3, they are equal. Here we got p of x equal to x power n into p of 1 by x. Look at these two equations, they are same, they are equal. So we can conclude p of x equal to x power n into p into 1 by x. So we can conclude that the equation 1 is a reciprocal equation. If you want to conclude the given equation is a reciprocal equation, the equation should satisfy any one of the two statements. That is a n equal to a naught. See, look at here, look at the equation 1 and 2 here. Here the two equations are same, the two equations are equal, so we can conclude a n equal to a naught. Here the coefficients of x power n are equal, so a n equal to a naught. Then coefficient of x power n minus 1 are also equal, so here our coefficient of x power n minus 1 is a n minus 1. Here our coefficient is a 1. क्या अगर कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स इज ए वन, क्या रहा कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स इज ए एन माइनस वन, सिमिलरली वी गॉट आवर रिक्वायर्ड रिजल्ट. सो हियर वी कैन कंक्लूड द इक्वेशन वन इज अ रेसिप्रोकल इक्वेशन. सी अंडर दैट हियर वी आर हैविंग सम नोट सम रिमार्क्स. Look at your book, page number 121. There are two remarks. A reciprocal equation cannot have zero as a solution. For a reciprocal equation, zero cannot be a solution. The coefficients and solutions are not restricted to be a real. Then there are two notes. Reciprocal equation of type 1 correspond to those in which the coefficient from the beginning are equal to the coefficient of a coefficient from the end. Reciprocal equation of type 1. In the reciprocal equation of type 1, the coefficients of the first and last term are equal. Then reciprocal equations of type 2, the coefficients at the beginning and the end are equal in magnitude but opposite in sign. Okay, there are a few more points. Here we don't have any proof. We should have some points. Look at your book, page number 122. There are some points. For an odd degree reciprocal equation of type 1, x equal to minus 1 must be a solution. Then, for an odd degree reciprocal equation of type 2, x equal to 1 must be a solution. For an even degree reciprocal equation of type 2, the middle term must be 0. Further, x equal to 1 and x equal to minus 1 are solution. For an even degree reciprocal equation of type 1, we can take x plus 1 by x or x minus 1 by x as y, and then we can solve by some other method or we can solve as usual. Then the last one, non-polynomial equation. See, suppose if I have 15 minus 2x equal to x. Look at this. This is not a polynomial, but we can make some change and then we'll solve as usual. Okay, now I'm going to squaring on both sides. What will happen? In the left side, 15 minus 2x equal to x square. Now I'm going to bring all the terms into right side. So what will happen? 0 equal to x square plus 2x minus 15. So x square plus 2x minus 15. Now this equation can be solved by splitting the middle term or formula method or any one method. Okay. For example, look at the example 3.29. Here we are having 2 cos square x minus 9 cos x plus 4 equal to 0. See, look at this. This is not a ordinary polynomial, but it looks like a polynomial. So, we'll make some change and then we can do the problem by a usual method. Here, we are having cos x. So, we can take cos x as a y. So, if I take cos x as y, what will happen? The equation becomes 2y square minus 9y plus 4 equal to 0. And then you can solve by any one method. Now, we are going to do exercise 3.5. Problem, exercise 3.5. Look at the 7th one. Seventh one, what's our problem? Solve the equation. Okay. Now, this is a even degree reciprocal equation of type 1. For this, what we have to do? First, we have to divide the whole equation by x square. So, I am going to divide the whole equation. This is a even degree reciprocal equation of type 1. This is type 1 reciprocal equation. Because here the leading coefficient and the constant are equal in magnitude as well as same in equal in sign. Okay, so first I'm going to divide the whole equation by x square. So what will happen? 6x square minus 5x minus 38 minus 5 by x plus 6 by x square equal to 0. Now I'm going to group in the x square term as well as x term separately. So what will happen? 6x square plus 6 by x square minus 5x minus 5 by x minus 38 equal to 0. Now from these two I'm going to take 6 as the common factor. So what will happen? X square plus 1 by x square. From these two I'm going to take minus 5 as the common factor. So what will happen? X plus 1 by x minus 38 equal to 0. Now what I'm going to do? Now I'm going to take x plus 1 by x as y. We can consider this as equation number 1. Before that, now I'm going to substitute x plus 1 by x as y. Before that, now I'm going to squaring on both sides. So what will happen? X plus 1 by x whole square equal to y square. A plus b whole square. So a square plus b square plus 2ab equal to y square. Now, x square plus 1 by x square equal to y square minus 2. See, look at the equation 1. Here we need the value of x square plus 1 by x square. No, so here we can substitute x square plus 1 by x square as y square minus 2. So what will happen? Equation 1 becomes 6 into x square plus 1 by x square y square minus 2 minus 5 into x plus 1 by x can be written as y minus 38 equal to 0. Now 6 into y square, 6y square minus 12 minus 5y minus 38 equal to 0. So 6y square minus 5y minus 50 equal to 0. Minus 300. Our multiplicative factor minus 300. Our additive factor minus 5. Okay. Now I'm going to x plus 1 by x as y. Now I'm going to solve this by splitting the middle term concept. So 6y square minus 20y plus 15y minus 50 equals 0. From this we can take 2y as the common factor. So 3y minus 10 plus, from this we can take 5 as the common, 3y minus 10 equal to 0. So y equal to minus 5 by 2 and y equal to 10 by 3. Now I'm going to substitute y equal to minus 5 by 2 and y equal to 10 by 3 in the assumption. So x plus 1 by x equal to y. Instead of y, I'm going to put minus 5 by 2. So x plus 1 by x equal to y. Instead of y, I'm going to put 10 by 3. Now x square plus 1 divided by x equal to 5 by 2. Cross multiplication. Now 2x square plus 2 equal to 5x. What will happen? So 2x square minus 5x plus 2 equal to 0. So here we can solve this by splitting the middle term concept. So 4 minus 5 minus 4 minus 1. So 2x square minus 4x minus x plus 2 equal to 0. So
from this we can take 2x as the common factor. So x minus 2 minus 1 into x minus 2 equal to 0. So x equal to 2, x equal to 1 by 2. We got two result, two roots. Now x square cross multiply, x square plus 1 divided by x equal to 10 by 3 cross multiply, 3x square plus 3 equal to 10x. Now I'm going to bring this into the left side. So 3x square minus 10x plus 3 equal to 0. So 9 minus 10, minus 9 minus 1. So what will happen? 3x square minus 9x minus 1x plus 3 equal to 0. From this we can take 3x as the common factor. So x minus 3 minus 1 into x minus 3 equal to 0. So x minus 3 into 3x minus 1 equal to 0. So we got x as 3 and 1 by 3. We got our 4 required values. We are going to find the real number satisfying the given equation. What's our given equation? 4 power x minus 3 into 2 power x plus 2 plus 2 power 5 equal to 0. We are going to find the real number satisfying this equation. What I am going to do? Look at the problem carefully. 4 can be written as 2 power 2. 4 can be written as 2 power 2 whole power x minus 3 into a power m plus n can be written as a power m into a power n. So 2 power x into 2 power 2 plus 2 power 5 is 32 equal to 0. Now a power m whole power n can be written as a power m whole power n can be written as a power n whole power n. The powers can be interchanged. So 2 power x whole power 2 minus 3 into 2 power x into 2 power 2 plus 32 equal to 0. Here our common factor is 2 power x. So I'm going to take 2 power x as y. Y square minus 3 into 4 12 y plus 32 equal to 0. Okay, so here we can solve this by a splitting the middle term concept. Here our multiplicative factor 32, additive factor minus 12, minus 8, minus 4. So our y values are 8 and 4. Okay, now I'm going to substitute y as 8 and 4 in equation 2. So 2 power x equal to y. Instead of y, I'm going to put 8. Now 2 power x equal to 8 can be written as 2 power 3. The base can be cancelled. So x equal to 3. Similarly, 2 power x equal to y. Instead of y, I'm going to put 4. 2 power x equal to 4. 2 power x equal to 4 can be written as 2 power 2. So the base can be cancelled. So x equal to 2. So our roots are x equal to 3 and x equal to 2. We got our required values. Even degree reciprocal equation of type 1. For this, what I am going to do? First, we are going to divide the whole equation by x square. I am going to divide the whole equation by x square. So, what will happen? 6x square minus 35x plus 62 minus 35 by x plus 6 by x square equal to 0. Now, I am going to group in the x square as well as x separately. So what will happen? 6x square plus 6 by x square minus 35x minus 35 by x plus 62 equal to 0. So what will happen? From this I'm going to take x 6 as the common factor. So x square plus 1 by x square. From this we can take minus 35 as the common factor. So x plus 1 by x plus 62 equal to 0. Now I'm going to take x plus 1 by x as y. x plus 1 by x as y. So you can take this as equation 2, you can take this as equation 1. So now I'm going to squaring on both sides. So what will happen? X plus 1 by x whole square equal to y square. So a plus b whole square form. So x square plus 1 by x square plus 2 equal to y square. So from this we can find x square plus 1 by x square as y square minus 2. We can substitute x square plus 1 by x square as y square minus 2 in the equation 1. X plus 1 by x equal to y is our assumption. So equation 1 becomes 6 into y square minus 2 minus 35 into, instead of this I'm going to put y plus 62 equal to 0. Now 6y square minus 12 minus 35y plus 62 equal to 0. So what will happen? 6y square minus 35y plus 50 equal to 0. 300 minus 35. So minus 20 minus 50. So 6y square minus 20y minus 15y plus 50 equal to 0. From this we can take 2y as the common factor. So 2y into 3y minus 10. From this we can take minus 5 as the common factor. So 3y minus 10 equal to 0. So y equal to 5 by 2 comma y equal to 10 by 3. We got our y values. Y as 5 by 2 and 10 by 3. Now we are going to substitute y as 5 by 2 and 10 by 3 in the assumption. So what's our assumption? X plus 1 by x equal to y. Now I'm going to substitute y as 5 by 2 in this. X plus 1 by x. We can go for the cross multiply. So x square plus 1 divided by x equal to y. Instead of y, I'm going to put 5 by 2 cross multiply. So 2x square plus 2 equal to 5x. Now 2x square minus 5x plus 2 equal to 0. So 2x square. Here we can solve this by splitting the middle term concept and a multiplicative factor 4, additive factor minus 5. So our factors, our required numbers will be minus 4, minus 1. So minus 4x minus x plus 2 equal to 0. So from this we can take 2 as 2x as the common. So x minus 2. From this we can take minus 1 as a common factor. So x minus 2. So 2x minus 1 into x minus 2 equal to 0. So our x values are 1 by 2 and 2. Now similarly x plus 1 by x equal to y. Instead of y, I'm going to put 10 by 3. So x plus 1 by x equal to, instead of y, you can put 10 by 3. Now cross, we can go for the cross multiply. So x square plus 1 over x equal to 10 by 3 cross multiply. So 3x square plus 3 equal to 10x. So we can bring the 10x into the left side. So 3x square minus 10x plus 3 equal to 0. Here our multiplicative factor 9, additive factor minus 10. So what will 3x square minus 9x minus x plus 3 equal to 0. So our factors will be x equal to 1 by 3 and 3. So our record values are 1 by 2, 2, 1 by 3, 3. Our required values. Then you can do the second one as the homework. Here our second one, second equation is x power 4 plus 3x cube minus 3x minus 1 equal to 0. This is a even degree reciprocal equation of type 2. So as we know, for this equation 1 and minus 1 are the solution. Then after that, you can do as usual. Thank you.